that your stomach?
Yep.
But I fed you.
It gurgled. We're back, and it's day 6.
Yep. Woo! All right, so we're going to try and be quick on this one. Since you go for it. Since we really screwed it up yesterday. So our Ann and Greg, Saints and Sinners Whiskey Club, the largest nonprofit whiskey club in the world. You're all, most of you are members.
Yeah.
If not,
yeah.
Become one. So today, we're back to Scotch.
Yes.
We are doing a blended Scotch today, and tell them the difference between a single malt and a blended Scotch. Because we've been doing this for 5 years,
by now you should know. But I just drink it, remember? That's the deal. Hmm. So I would say that if it's blended, they've taken two different and mixed them together.
Yeah. Kind of. You're not wrong.
No, but I'm not completely right.
Quick history or quick background on classification. So single malt means it's a whiskey made of malted barley from a single distillery.
Yes.
So you could have 3 or 5 or 6 different kinds of malt, malted barley in there, but it's from a single distillery. So a blended Scotch whiskey can be a bunch of different single malt whiskeys
mixed
blended together.
Mixed. Yeah, blended.
Or a blended, I think that might be single malt blend, I don't know. But then there's also, if you throw grain whiskey into it too. So this is a blended malt Scotch whiskey. So what that tells me, without doing a ton of research, is these are all single malts blended together and there's no grain. So I think I may have put on your list and on the stickers that this is from Naked Grouse. I believe that's who distills it, and I could be wrong, and there we go. But this is a 43 horsepower or 86 proof blended malt Scotch whiskey from what country of the world? Scotch whiskey.
Scotch?
Yeah.
Scotland.
There you go.
Glad you Sorry, didn't. I was thinking of what I
Glad
was smelling.
You didn't say Scotchland. it's a blend of single malts. It's aged in first fill Oloroso sherry casks. So Oloroso is a specific Spanish sherry.
Yeah.
It's going to be sherry casks are typically European oak, which gives a more of a spicier flavor profile than American oak, I think, which is Alba. Could be wrong.
Yeah.
The genus and species and all that good stuff. We won't totally nerd out. So, Anne, what do you get on the nose?
Oh, this smells delicious. It's like creamsicle with extra whipped cream and orange to me.
That is like cake frosting.
It is. Yeah. It's super sweet smelling, isn't it?
My Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Cherry, what's
compote?
What is compote?
It's cooked. It's like a bunch of cooked fruits, or just maybe one, but it's cooked in the oven, baked in the oven.
Sweet, decadent.
It is.
I'm hoping the taste
lives up to the smell.
Lives up to the nose.
Yeah. All right, I'm going in.
It's like peaches with brown sugar
on it. Oh, wow. You're going to think I'm crazy, but it's like mysterious. You drink it, and I got a full mouthful of like sweet and orange and cherry, and then by the time I swallowed it, it was something completely different.
That's freaking good.
Yeah.
At least to me. Like, taste is subjective.
It's
some of you may be like, this is like panther piss.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was like a journey, though, when I drank
it. It's like oily. Mm-hmm. I mean, obvious sherry influence with it being first fill. Thick tasting. I mean, mm-hmm. it's my sweet spot. I mean, I love viscous, oily coating type whiskeys. But it has just that almost like a toffee pudding.
Mm-hmm.
Raspberry jam, like a creme brulee with caramel or caramel on it. That is just rich.
I get it, creme brulee. I can't talk now. Brulee is definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely can taste that as well. Good. It's that like baked crispy sugar on top and then smooth underneath.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of a shorter finish though, surprisingly, yes. For as viscous and thick as the whiskey tastes to me. A little bit of raisin, but interesting now, like as I sit here, the front side of my palate
mm-hmm.
is almost like a dark chocolate cocoa powder. Like the old Hershey's baking powder stuff. The nose on that's amazing.
It's all right, yeah.
So here's the kicker with this one. Price point, $25.
Woo!
So to me, this is an example of why you don't need $100, $150
mm-mm.
whiskey. I think most people would be very challenged in a blind tasting if I lined up two or three scotches that, and if you like sherry influence or, mm-hmm. you know, wine cask influence scotches, that you wouldn't think this was a great whiskey. Yeah. Hopefully, not knowing the price point before that, you thought it was a good whiskey.
Yeah. But. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know. I would never, ever think it was a Scotch. I don't know. I hope that's not saying something bad to them, the people that have made it. But I think it's amazing that it's a Scotch, which usually I expect to be kind of harsh or than the others. This is
completely
the opposite.
Typically, if you don't mind a wine finish or a finished matured whiskey, and what I mean is like ex-bourbon barrels is your typical or your classic aging barrel that you'll use in flavor profile for a Scotch or an Irish whiskey. You know, sherry, port, Madeira, Marsala, some of these other ones, Pinot, you know, they're getting into all different ones. So if you like those finishes, it's typically going to kind of, if you think of a spirit, like even a younger one that has like these jagged peaks and valleys,
mm-hmm.
to me, when you mature in bourbon, it doesn't really round those off or fill in the valleys.
Yes.
But when you age in a wine barrel or a, you know, of the sort, I think the sherry and the port tend to round off.
Right. Fill in.
The tops and kind of fill in that valley. Yeah. So it's more like this. So probably why I really like them, but you can also get the layers like the raisins, the dates, the, you know, stewed, almost like stewed fruits in there.
Yeah.
Et cetera. All right.
All right.
So we're over again.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right.
So one of the things we've got to get back to. So what has been your favorite whiskey so far? So we are 6 days in. What's your favorite far, Ann?
Oh, I have to think this is my favorite tonight.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah. It's almost like dessert for me, it feels like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. Like, it's either Orchard the Irishman
House too.
Or I'm going to go with this one too.
Yeah.
I think this is our top dog.
It was
a
really happy surprise.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
So shout outs. Okay. We're going to shout out to the two aunts.
Yeah.
The aunties.
Auntie Mag and Auntie R.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I thought it was appropriate because, you know, these are Ann's mom's younger sisters.
Yeah.
We've heard a lot of stories about them. And I just, without going into all that, I figured the fact that it says naked on here would be most appropriate.
The Kane girls got a little crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They did. All right. Super happy to have both of you ladies with us. And maybe you can get your kids, influence your kids to start drinking whiskey too. So, Annie, toast us out.
All right. May your heart stay young, the whiskey be old, the cork loose, and the adventures bold.
See you tomorrow.
Cheers.
I do like that one.
That is so good. Lucky. I could get in trouble with that, I think.
There you go.